Welcome to the Account Solutions. This channel is dedicated to bring you solutions to your everyday tasks in areas of bookkeeping, business administration, accounting, and taxation. If you like what you're doing here, kindly click on the subscription button and support us. Enjoy the rest of this tutorial. Welcome back. This is a continuation of our video tutorial on the Bequi template. Let's see in Excel how to post the opening balances. So you click on Navigate, go to Admin Panel and Adjust Stock. So we are here. So let's assume the new product we added. Remember we added this EW slice rules. So as we already have some products for it, click on it. The date of transaction, let's say it was on the 2nd of October 2020. It was done during the morning shift, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Using for adjustment, you can just say weekly stock count, you know, then quantity, let's say we had 100, we didn't put it. Adjustment type, add or less, I'm adding to the system. So you just select add, that's all. Then you post to give you a control dialog box to check if everything is okay. If you are sure of your entry, say yes. Your entry has been posted. Okay, so that's it. So let's see if what we've posted has populated in the stock database. Go to navigate, go to admin panel, go to edit products, then close all these forms. If you check now the EW slice rules, look at stock adjustment, we have 100. Then inventory balance is now 100. So you can see that the system is working. It has captured your product that you just updated. If you want to, if you had made a mistake, it's supposed to be 100, but it's supposed to be, let's say, 150, but you're going to put 100. And now I can adjust this also. You also go back to navigate, admin panel, adjust stock. So type the date of adjustment. It is a 3rd of October 2020. It was during the ninth shift that I did this. The reason was reversal of double posting or caution of wrong posting. Then product the same EW slash rules. Quantity is 50. I want to less from the stock. Then you post. Okay, fine. Let's go back to admin panel and edit stock. You now see we now have adjustment that we made in was 100. What we now got off was 50. We now have an inventory balance of 50. So the system does not net off in the database. It captures all your additions and subtractions separately, then come to this product database and net it off to get your inventory balance. So let's assume all is well and going well for us. Our bakery is up and running. We want to start posting production, package, sales, auction, missing items, and the rest of them. So let's just go after production records. We'll go to products, package, and transfer to sales. After that, we'll look at product, package, and receive from or sent to another branch. We'll also look at posting sales, auction sales, damaged product, or missing product. And finally, we'll look at how the basic report is available here and how to edit and update some basic data. So go back to navigate. Our first point of call is to record production. So you can see this navigate form has three sections. We have the setup, which we've discussed. We have the post transactions, which we're going to do now, and we have the reports. So post transaction, let's receive finished products for packaging. We are finished producing this bread. We want to now send them to packaging. So click on receive finished product from packaging. So we are here. Do not post the product from other branches or product from packaging here. So just we're looking at what we receive from production unit. So type the date you receive it. This is on the 3rd of October 2020. It was during the morning shift. And the control number or logbook number or docket number was whatever it is. supervisor in charge was Peter Pan, for example. The product was EW/Zoos. You can add, you can put up to, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 20 product at once based on this interface. But let us post one. So we produce 1,000 items. Remember, we had 50 before. So we just post. Now, if you're not sure, you just say no. Now, let me explain some of the features here. If I don't put in a date and I say post, you ask, you kindly enter the date of the transaction. If there's a date and there is no shift, it will ask you to enter the shift date. If there's a shift and there is no ref number, it asks you for the ref or log number. If there's a number and there is no supervisor, ask you for the name of the supervisor. So it's important you do that. And if you don't select any product here, it will say at least you must select one product to post. Okay. And if you do that and there is no quantity, it will tell you to put in at least a quantity to post. Okay. So with that, we are good to go. You now post. Okay. Fine. So we have posted 1,000 units of items to our production. Next stop is to receive from package. So let's assume we've produced 1,000 units of EW slice rolls. We'll package only 850 of them. Now we cannot sell that 1,000 because it's not available for sale. Let's go to dashboard and see something there. Your dashboard, look at the EW slice rolls. You see system balance is 50 as of today. As of 2nd of October, it was 100 when we posted the first opening balance. But as of today, it was 50. So you cannot sell more than 50. That's what it means. But look at this other table here. We have EW slice rolls, 1,000 production, package 0, unpackage 1,000. So you see, without you packaging any of these products, you cannot make sales because you have only 50 here. If you want to try to make sale, let's just experiment that to make sale. Go to, don't say because I have 1,000 finished products, I can sell them. No. Until you package them and post in the system, you cannot sell them. So go to navigate. Let's try and enter sales to level one customer. Select EW slice rule. You see, you have stock level 50. You cannot sell more than 50. So if I try to sell 100, for example, to tell you, you don't have enough stock to meet this demand because you're having minus 50 if you sell 100 because you have only 50 available. So that's to explain how this dashboard works. You can only sell what you've packaged. So we have 1,000 units available as of today, but they're not packaged. We have 0 packaged and have only 50 are available in the system. So to do that, you need to package them and receive them to the system. So you go back to your navigate and receive finished product from packaging. So click on that. The date, I'm receiving them on the 3rd of October 2020. The shift was a morning shift, for example. The docket number from the packaging unit is, packaging staff was went oven. Then the product we have is EW slice rolls. The package 850 for us to sell. So you post, okay, good. So you go to your dashboard again. You will see you have 900 available as of today, system balance to post. You see, we have production 1,000, package is 850, on package is what, 150. So you can be able to see what they've not packaged, you know, based on the date you've selected. So that's how you post items that we package for sales. So let's assume we are sending some of this item. We have some branches that need us to supply them. You know, we don't have these items. Go to navigate, say send package to branches or receive from other branches. Let's assume a customer comes to our branch and wants EW jumbo bread. I don't have it in our stock, so we don't even produce it here. We will produce some on that branch or location. What you need to do, you have to add in the product first. So go to new product, you add EW jumbo. you now put jumbo family loaf, for example. Price level one is 400, 450, 475, and 500. For example, cottage is around 400. You not add that product, fine. Then want to receive this product from on that branch, you don't have it here. So if you go to your dashboard, it's zero, you don't have this product here. EW Jumbo is zero, it's not available on our stock list. So you can go to navigate and receive package product from other branches. So the date I'm receiving it is on the today, 4th of October 2020. The shift we receive it from is, let's say, morning shift. The WayBee number from that branch is this. Then received by who? I receive by a staff user, for example. The product is EW Jumbo. We received 300 quantity post. Go back to your dashboard. You will see we have 300 available now for sale as of today. You can see production zero, package zero, and package zero. So we have production zero for this product Jumbo because we've not produced it before in this branch, but we have it available in the system. So you can see all these other indices are all zero because it's not, wasn't produced from the system here. All right, so next stop is to assume we have this EW slice rules, 900 available for sale, but a branch needs it, we don't have it, and the customer in that branch needs it. So what do we need to do? All we need to do is to post, send package product to branches. So the same procedure, so it was done today. The shift was morning shift, maybe number to that branch was sent by staff user. So the product we sent was EW slice rolls. We sent 500 pieces to them, post. Okay, so you can see if you go to your dashboard again, you see we have only 400 left of this product now, because we sent 500 to other branches. Now it is now the branch that it was sent to that will record it in their sales. Don't capture it in your sales, because to be like, we are consolidating the entire sales of the bakery, you will be double counting that sale. So just post it as quantity out from your system. The branch that receive it will receive it as quantity received from other branch, and they'll not sell, you know, normal sales from their own system. That's how it works. So next is let's now go to the sales. We want to sell out all this product. We have 400 available for EW slice rules and 300 for Jumbo. To navigate, and you go to sales to level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4. Okay, so they are the same thing, just that the prices will change. So I want to sell to level 1. You can see the price is 50 naira for this EW slice rules. I want to make sales for Jumbo. Jumbo is 400 for level 1 sales. I want to sell 100 pieces. So we have this. Total sales is 45,000 naira. So the date of the is on the 4th of October 2020. The shift is, it's a morning shift. Now, let's check these prices for level 2 customers. Navigate level 2 customers. Now you have 70 and 450. That's against 50 and 400. If you go to level 3 customers, make this sales, the price will change to 90 and 475. If you go to level 4 customers to make the same sales, it will change to 110 and 500. So you should be very careful of which customer you're making sales to, based on each level of sale, because the prices are the same. You don't have any option to change the price yet. If you change the price when you go to your product, edit product list, then you change the price. So the same thing happens for all the sales. So to select the customer, can only post one customer per time. The customer is this last guy, Big World Eatery. The reference is a receipt number. You gave the customer a receipt and a docket or a ticket to put the receipt number here, for example, and the ticket number here also. If there is no number here, just put something here like zero here and leave it like that. But just put a number, you know, if there is a ticket number, as the case may be, then you say post. Now remember, if you don't populate everything here, for example, let's remove the customer and say post, it will ask you for a customer, select a buyer. So you must put a customer and you try to sell more than you have and you say post. It will tell you you have a product that has limited stock. You cannot sell from this product. Please check. You can see you don't have enough stock to meet this demand. So you need to sell what you have. Okay. So don't go and collect money in advance to sell to a customer. You must ensure you have a product available. So if you see a product that are not packaged, talk to the packaging guys to package the product and release to the sales department for them to get to the system before they make the sales. So you post your sales. Okay, what's your dashboard? We have available item 300, 200. You can see them here. They're available because we've made some of those sales. You go to your admin panel, go to edit product list, close all these. Look at that jumbo and slice and slice rules. You can see H50 from packaging, from other branches, 300 for the jumbo. Then you can see sales 100 to other branches 500. At the end of the day, you can see inventory balance 300 and 200. So this is a real-time inventory system that gives your stock update at time. As long as you push correctly and you push on the same day, you get your report immediately. There's no issue of trying to prepare reports. Everything is available once you enter your data correctly. So once you've posted the sales, you can also post for other levels of sales. The same thing, there's no difference. You can also auction finished products. So here we have, you want to auction some products, auction this and this. Date is 4th of October 2020. Let's say 3rd of October 2020. We're doing that during the evening shift. The way B will carry the items to a location, for example, then the ref number, whatever it is. So you can see now, look at the original level for price. So this is the lowest price level in the system. So you need to now put your auction price, you know, to check how much you are selling. As we are selling this for 120 or 150. But this just gives you an idea of how much the lowest price should have been if it was sold to a level 4 customer. And again, I want to sell, I have 17 left, 22 left. I'm auctioning the whole 17, I'm auctioning the whole 92. Okay, so you can see you have zero balance, new stock level is zero. I try to auction 95. Tell me you don't have enough much stock to auction. So I'm auctioning 92. That's all, nothing much again to do. So you just say post and select the staff in charge. Someone was in charge of this function. I put demo admin was in charge of the function. Then you say post, okay, and you're fine. So if you go back to your dashboard, you see that this product EW Fresh 0, Nature 0. You want to check gross balance on the third. Thought you can see the balances. I had 10 yesterday, 11 yesterday. Okay, as of second, I had a stock balance of 240, 460 of second. But as of fourth today, I have zero balances. So that's how you post the auction sales. Now, if you want to post damaged or bad products, there's no option to post that here. You need to go to your admin panel. It's from here I begin to look at damaged products, but for now it's not set up yet because of don't want people to be posting damaged products or missing product without authorization. So if you want it to be populated, then you can just make that request. We'll add a button for that thing to add post damaged products or missing products. So for damaged product, the interface is the same thing with other interface with Sync. Type in the date, let's say 4th 20, the shift was morning shift, and there was a docket obviously that was issued, was approved by the MRD. The product that was damaged is this product spy, let's assume 5 of them got bad, just a post. That's it. Then to post missing products, maybe some products we are missing out of P3, or some staff took some products and hid it, you know, very funny stuff. And also post that here, 10:20. It was during the morning shift, you know, staff that was booked. Which staff was booked for this loss? And just put the staff name, staff that was booked for this loss. And the products that was missing, you see this product was missing, 5 of them. Just say post, same way. Good. So let's just go back to our dashboard. You see your product level, all that you've done, they're all here. You can see products level, they're all here. We have come to the end of this section. Thank you for staying with us. See you in the next video continuation of this video tutorial on our bakery template. Kindly subscribe and click on the notification bell so that you will get notified when we release subsequent videos. Cheers.